really they're insignificant compared to what God has forgiven us. So He's forgiven us an enormous sum, and we are asked to forgive often little. So in Joanne's case, which is a true story, it was quite a lot, but she experienced that healing when she was able to forgive. Instead of seeking vengeance, she let go. And how could she do this? So she could do it because she was prayerful. So she had a good prayer life, and God gave her the grace to do this and the courage to do this, to confront the attacker. So through prayer, God forms our hearts. And if we don't pray constantly, we won't have the grace to overcome sin. So through prayer comes grace and healing. So this was necessary as a part of her healing, and God provided the rest and healed her completely. So she was completely free of any unforgiveness in her life. So often people carry on feuds for many, many years. It can go on for 30, 40 years, even up until their deaths. People refuse to forgive one another. So it reminds me of a little story about two men walking through a desert, and they were great friends. But anyway, as they're walking through the desert, they had an argument, and the other slapped his friend in the face. But instead of saying everything, the man who was slapped in the face bent down and wrote in the sand, "My best friend slapped me in my face, but I forgive him." And then they moved on. They eventually came to an oasis in the desert, and they decided to have a swim. So as they were swimming, the one who had been slapped in the face started to sink in a mire. And his friend reached out and pulled him out, saved him. And then he wrote on a stone, "My best friend just saved my life." And his friend said, "Why in the first instance did you write on the sand and now you write on a stone?" Well, he said, "With writing on the sand, eventually the winds come and blow it away. And that's how it is forgiveness. Eventually we get over it. But when it's written on the sand, it's permanent. Written on the stone, it's permanent." Forgiveness is permanent when we forgive from the heart, when we really let go completely and move on. So we're all called to forgive totally. That's the command of Jesus.